Dear students, welcome to our today's class. Our today's class is for the students of class 9 and into the things I would like to represent or I would like to introduce myself with you. I am EBNUL, assistant teacher in English at HOSSAIN School and College, BOGURA. And our today's class is on English second paper, and our today's topic connectors, and this is the part 2 of that class connectors, because in the previous class we discussed some elementary ideas about connectors. So before starting our today's class, I would like to give you some hints that we discussed in the previous classes. In the previous class, we learned what is connectors. Connectors or linking words are words used to join words, phrases and clauses together. That means the connectors are used to join the words, phrases and clauses together, and we can term these items, the connectors, as the joining words. So connectors are some joining words. That means the word are which are used to join words, phrases and clauses. So we already learned the what is the connectors and when to use connectors. And in the previous class, we learned some of connectors or some of words used to join words, phrases and clauses and used as connectors. And in today's class, we are going to learn some more words which are used as connectors to use join and words, phrases and clauses together. Okay, let's get started with the board. Uses of different connectors. Before, after. These are two connectors which are usually used to express the time of function. That means these are the words which generally or usually expresses a time function. Let's have a couple of examples. To, express time of function. That means these connectors are used to express time of function. He had released the station before the train started. So we can see the sentence, and in this sentence there are two clauses. He had reached the station and the train started. So in this sentence, the two clauses are joined together by the connectors before. So we can see that this very connector before expresses some time of function. That means it expresses the time function. And we can see the sentence, he had reached the station before the train is started. Now, another example. We reach the station after the train another example and then another sentence, and in this sentence there are two clauses. We reach the station and the rain had stopped. So this is the another sentence, and in this sentence there are also two clauses. We reach the station and after the rain had stopped. So these two clauses are joined together by the connectors after. Let's have some other connectors. Till, until, as long as long as. And these are the connectors which are generally used to express the time of function. To express time of function. And we can see that these connectors are also used to express the time of function. Let's have a couple of examples. Wait there until I return. So we can see that in this sentence there are two clauses. Joined together by the connector until. Stay healthy. As long as you live in the world. a sentence, and in this sentence there are also two clauses, steadily and you live in a world. These two clauses are joined together by the connector as long as. So we can say that in every cases these connectors are used to express the time of function. Let's have another connectors. When provided though, although these connectors are also used to express the time of function, to express time of function. I visited the place while I was a student. When he heard the news. So in these two sentences we can see that there are in the first sentence there are two clauses are joined together by the connector while, and in the second sentence also there are two clauses joined together by the connectors of while. So all these connectors are used to express the function or time function, that means the time of function. In case, this is the connectors. Sometimes the students may get perplexed that how to use these connectors in case. So now we are going to learn the connector in case. That means how to use the connector in case in the sentences. To be to express to express doing something to express doing something as something might happen later. So notice carefully that when to use the connector in case. So the connector in case is used to express doing something as something might happen later. Let's have an example. Write the names in case you forget. Write the name in case you forget them. So in this sentence there are two clauses. Write the names in case you forget them. These two clauses are joined by the connector in case. So this connector is very important. So I think you will practice the usage of this character. Let's in order to express purpose. This connector in order to generally used to express purpose. Let's have a couple of examples. I went to market in order to buy some books. So notice the sentence here. The clauses and the phrases. This clauses. I went to market, and we can see the phrases buy some books, and these two are connected or joined by the connector in order to. And this connector expresses the purpose. So these are the major connectors we already learned, and I think this class will be very benefited for you. And if you practice these connectors and their uses again and again, then you will be able to solve the questions set in your question paper. So practice this more and more, and you will be able to do better in your exam. So thank you all. See you.